Oh hi, I'm the Heretic. Check this out. Someone made a video response to me. I'm important. Okay, maybe not really, but I am genuinely thrilled to be receiving this kind of feedback, as it'll either inform and improve my content or amuse me. I win either way. Let's check it out. Link in the description. Hit it!
You know, I always say I'll get to it, but anyways, what better time to start this than now, right? Especially since I met this one particular YouTuber, just under 500 subs, who makes videos of this whole so-called, quote-unquote, anarcho-capitalism.
Well, I'm flattered that I'm your introduction to anarcho-capitalism. Enjoy your stay. It's happy hour on recreational McNukes for the next 20 minutes.
Which basically says that if you remove all government, embrace free markets, and look after ourselves first, others go last, society would just magically prosper. Well,
oh crap, you just cut yourself off. To address your point, yes, we want to abolish government and embrace free markets, but no, we don't want to have everyone look after themselves first and others last. That's a lie, and whoever told you that was lying to you. Furthermore, there's nothing magical about the very real improvement society would enjoy by eliminating violence from interpersonal relationships.
Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow? No, says the man in Washington, it belongs to the poor. No, says the man in the Vatican, it belongs to God. No, says the man in Moscow, it belongs to everyone.
BioShock was a repetitive snooze fest of a shooter. Andrew Ryan wasn't a commentary on anarcho-capitalism, but objectivism. His name is a corruption of Ayn Rand. I mean, come on. Besides, we totally go to video games to get our hard-hitting analysis on political philosophy. Even so, how was he wrong? Please, enlighten me.
Until some rogue nation just comes rolling into your little encampment and kills everyone, you know. Most Muslims. Yep, and that leads to the main problem with your narrative, ANCAPs. You're all a bunch of cuckish globalists.
There's an argument in there somewhere. I already addressed the issue of enemy states rolling in, and I know you watched that video, so you're clearly just ignoring my points.
Same problem that led to the mass murder of innocent Europeans for the simple reason of not submitting Islam. The same globalism that led to mass Muslim rape gangs. The same globalism that's destroying Western democratic values as we know it.
Believe it or not, I despise what's happening in Europe too. I had a video criticizing what's being done in Germany subtitled in German so that native Germans could watch it too. So I've done my part. Why do you think I'm a globalist though? I'm not. Is it because I'm not a nationalist? Don't throw me into your globalism-nationalism dichotomy. Both are forms of collectivism, and I am an individualist. Anarcho-capitalism is simply individualism taken to its logical conclusion.
I'm going to be focusing on a certain someone who just happens to put out this certain video in which he, a self-avowed anarcho-capitalist, is revealed to be a Catholic.
Now, I say this as a practicing Catholic. Can confirm, am Catholic. So, is Catholicism and anarcho-capitalism incompatible? Given your level of understanding of my philosophy, I'm looking forward to you telling me what I'm supposed to think.
Let's watch the part of the video in which he essentially stays true to his name and commits heresy against the same Catholic Church he claims to be a part of.
He just wanted to be liked by the Chinese anti-theist totalitarian regime. At least Judas got some silver out of it when he sold out Jesus Christ. Yep, I said that and I stand by it. Still waiting to hear what your problem is other than it's cringy, whatever that means.
The Catholic Church was never really a bastion of liberal values and has historically suppressed anyone who spoke out against it, or anyone who spoke out against the exclusive, elitist, corrupt clergy that claimed that you had to do everything that they said, word for word, otherwise you wouldn't be saved.
Okay, I mean, yeah, the Catholic Church has had a rather sordid history, to put it mildly, but the values of Catholicism are independent of the institution. In the same way, the American values of limited government, self-reliance, and self-governance are independent of the American government.
Simple faith in God wasn't good enough. They wanted people to conform the feudalistic status quo at a time, basically holding the peasants as more hostages and guilted them into toiling the fields, basically as slaves, while the priesthood lived in luxury. Disgusting!
You do know that feudalism existed independent of the church, right? I'm not defending feudalism. I'd never do that. It was reprehensible and disgusting. But assuming the church is uniquely guilty of this is just absurd.
This is exactly why Protestantism took root. To protest, as in protest in Protestantism, the church is dictatorial stranglehold over the grace of God, and to awaken people to the truth that salvation lies in the hands of the practitioner and their faith alone.
Feudalism also had nothing to do with the Protestant Reformation. Have you read Martin Luther's 95 Theses? He was protesting the church selling indulgences, which were permission slips to sin or a get-out-of-jail-free card for loved ones in purgatory. I happen to agree with Martin Luther on this for obvious reasons. If there is a purgatory, the idea that the Pope has any power there is ludicrous. Was Martin Luther a heretic? Absolutely. But on this channel, heresy is A-OK. I mean, it's not like I put the words actual heresy on the thumbnails of my Bible videos or anything.
Sola Fide! Not an unelected, unaccountable, bureaucratic body. With all that blood on their hands, it comes as no surprise the Catholic Church, through most of its history, supported slavery. Any Catholic missionaries speaking out against the rulings were excommunicated and or killed.
You are correct. That is absolutely abhorrent and reprehensible.
Oh, but you argue the Catholic Church has reformed itself in the 20th century? That they all of a sudden became nice and just sometime around the 1890s onwards?
The Council of Trent, the First Vatican Council, and the Second Vatican Council. You just completely ignore those, don't you?
Except, no. In fact, the church not only encouraged, but also directly inspired the creation of many clerically fascist governments who had Catholicism as part of their state ideology.
And here he's just going to list Wikipedia articles of fascist parties that have the word Catholic somewhere in there, with zero argument, context, or explanation. Because he presents zero arguments, I don't have to refute them. Though you know he was reaching when he circled the words Roman Catholic while ignoring the context of the sentence. Say classy, XBL Spartan X170.
All of these Catholic regimes killed millions more and caused a f***ing world war, all because they wanted nothing more than, just like in the Middle Ages, the extermination of all supposed heretics, even past World War II.
What world war are you talking about? Serbian nationalists started World War I, albeit unintentionally, and the National Socialist German Workers' Party in the 30s and 40s was openly hostile to Catholics and Christians. The Purple Triangle, for example, was a concentration camp badge used to identify Bible students. There was also a little thing called the Kirchenkampf, and I'm probably butchering that pronunciation. I would encourage you to look it up because it kinda disproves everything you think about Catholic Nazis. Here's a hint. The Nazis were militant atheists.
The Catholics in America openly supported the equally oppressive, racist, white supremacist Democratic Party, and even to this day, won't let a woman preach the Word of God.
I'm sorry, what? But why do they need to? Why must the church, founded by the apostles of Jesus Christ, conform itself and its traditions to your sensibilities? So this is as far as I care to go, because he's pretty much done. This whole video is based on misinformation and half-truths that take a lot of what I say out of context, and hardly any addresses anything I actually say. It's just an excuse to give him an outlet for his anti-theism.
My final word, f*** the Catholic Church.
I'll give him some credit, though. He went 5 minutes criticizing the Catholic Church, and he didn't once beat the pedophile priest dead horse. But let's be honest here, he just wanted me to reply to him and give his channel some clicks. I mean, he clearly wanted my attention. Well, he got his wish. Here I am. Hello. But I'm not here to help his channel. All I would ask is that he, in the future, try to address my points or the flaws in my arguments. Now, is the Catholic Church a perfect institution for God's infinite benevolence and beneficence? Hell no. And so I criticize it because I love the church and I want it to do better. Its current pope takes after Judas, Has the Catholic Church also made mistakes in the past? Of course it has, and I'll criticize those too. I don't claim to be the perfect Catholic either, but I want to do better, and I long for the humility to recognize errors in my own way. Hopefully this is a good explanation of where I'm coming from, because unless he argues in good faith, I'm not going to be doing another video response to this guy. May God bless you all. Questions, comments, critique? Did he bring up any points you thought interesting? Any prayers you'd like to say? Like, share, and subscribe to become a heretic today.